The other members of the Board of Education, and I ask that they please stand as I call their name. First of all, our Vice President, Karen Olajarski, Kathleen Kapusta, Lynn Lasky, and Tom Van Driscoll. Thank you. Today is a happy day for all of us who are here for the 77th commencement of Independence High School. It is a happy day for the graduates who are leaving. It is a day that the parents are especially proud of their children who are graduating. It has been a long road to this day, but it is here, and I say congratulations. Today, we heard from four graduating seniors. Chris Holdick, the past. Rachel Smith, the threshold of the rest of our education. Carly Chihaki, 20 years from now. And Megan Velada, beyond the bubble. A common theme in these presentations is the future. The future is certainly an appropriate subject for graduation day. Today, we are celebrating the successful accomplishments of the members of the class of 2002. Looking back, these graduating seniors have just completed a major step of their lives. Looking forward, it is useful to recall the past. Graduates, you have already experienced one of the most important lessons in life, and that is, failure is a building block of success. Let me repeat that. Failure is a building block of success. Failure may seem like an unusual theme for a commencement speech, but failure is one of life's most crucial lessons. Let's remember some of the setbacks these young people have experienced so far and what the future may hold. As an infant attempting to take those first steps, a child often falls. After numerous attempts, success eventually comes. How exciting it is. Most of us remember the pride we felt upon learning to ride a two-wheel bicycle. Can you remember also the many attempts that took place before success finally came? Attempting to make the starting lineup on an athletic team or being inducted into the National Honor Society is another endeavor which for some took more than one try. Sometimes it took 2 to 3 years before success eventually came. These experiences illustrate a life lesson that complements your academic learning. Don't let setbacks keep you from trying. Always pick yourself up and try again. Your school days may be behind you, but lessons never end. Looking to the future. One example is seeking to win a promotion at work. Sometimes it seems that others get promoted and you don't. This can appear to be a setback, but keep trying. Success will eventually come. Another example is when an employer decides to downsize or move to another city or state. This can be a major setback in one's life. At that time, one needs to pause and reassess one's skills and goals and attempt to land other employment. How often it is said that after a major setback like that takes place, an even better opportunity arises. There are times when you feel that no matter how hard you try, you cannot accomplish enough. A professional baseball player who doesn't get a hit 7 out of 10 times at bat is considered successful. In fact, his .300 batting average is considered outstanding. Life is that way. No matter how hard you try, you will not attain every single one of your goals. However, you can accomplish a great deal, even as the great baseball player who only gets 3 hits out of every 10 times at bat. The graduates are to be commended. The because they have truly experienced what it takes to succeed. While we are celebrating their accomplishments today, we also need to remember the tremendous efforts and sometimes heartbreaks that they have gone through to be here. It will be important to recall those efforts as you grow through life's journey. Remember, learning never ends. In summary, let me reiterate that setbacks, even failures, are building blocks for lifetime successes. The only way to avoid failure is to never try. There are two kinds of people in this world: those who make things happen and those who watch things happen. Obviously, it's those in the first group who make the world a better place for all of us. The class of 2002 has made a great start in establishing itself as a collection of individuals who make things happen. On behalf of the Board of Education, I extend to both the graduating seniors and to their parents sincere and heartfelt congratulations. Thank you for making independent schools a part of your life.
Good afternoon. Members of the class of 2002, today we celebrate your graduation from Independence High School. We recognize your many accomplishments, both in the classroom and in co-curricular areas as well. But at the same time, we respect the challenges that lie ahead as you embark on your journey into an unknown future. I feel a sense of confidence and optimism in your abilities to meet the challenges that lie ahead. Never lose sight of who you are, where you have come from, and what you can become. The rich experiences afforded you in our schools, the encouragement and support that you have received from teachers, members of our city government, and the people of Independence, coupled with the love and care of your parents, families, and grandparents, all constitute assets that will help you fulfill your goals and dreams. As you leave us with this rich heritage, I know that we share a deep appreciation for our families and our community, that we love our land and our country and the precepts of our democratic society. We cherish our rights and those of each and every citizen of our country. We believe that all individuals can affect their own destiny by working hard to achieve goals. We believe in our own self-worth, which can grow with service to fellow man. We believe in the inalienable rights of all people the world over. In closing, I hope that you'll be able to look back at your high school experience, your friends, your family, your community, and your country, and see the order, the purpose, the beauty in all of them, and realize that there is a power and force that has created this beauty and order. If you can see where you as an individual fit into this beautiful order of things and how you may serve to perpetuate the peace and order of God's beautiful world, you will have found the key to success. May the peace of the Lord be with you along the way.
I would also like to welcome the Board of Education, Mr. Laurenzi, our faculty, parents, friends, and members of the class of 2002 for our 77th annual commencement exercise at Independence High School. I'd like to offer a special thanks to the teachers of Independence Schools who have joined us for this memorable afternoon. Your efforts, along with those of the many, many parents in our audience today, have contributed greatly in making this day possible. During Friday's award assembly, the academic strength of this class was made very apparent. 93% of this year's seniors have been accepted into colleges and universities. 23 members have earned an honors diploma based upon state-adopted guidelines. 18 members of the class have received the Presidential Award for Educational Excellence. 71 members of the class of 2002 will be attending 20 different universities located in six states. And additionally, these same students have earned close to $1 million in scholarships for academic and athletic merit. Both academic and school leadership has been displayed by our class officers, our student council officers, our class representatives, our valedictorian, and our salutatorian. These accomplishments point to the attainment of academic excellence measured in local, state, and national competitions. I will remember you, the class of 2002, for the many contributions you have made to our high school. From the first day that I met you in August, I have witnessed your tremendous growth. And as I have stated many times, this has been an outstanding school year due to the leadership of our seniors. They have done everything that I've asked them to do. I commend you for your many accomplishments, both in the classroom and in co-curricular activities. I hope your memories of Independence High School will be as positive as my memories are of you, your high school principal. And now, as principal of Independence High School, I certify that these ladies and gentlemen have met all requirements for graduation set forth by the Independence School Board and the State of Ohio. I present this class to you, Mr. Fourney, and recommend that they be granted their diplomas signifying graduation from Independence High School as a class of 2002. I would ask that the audience please hold all of your applause until all student names have been called so that each of them receives the recognition that they truly deserve.
Michael L. Kostick III. Michael Anthony Charley. Lori Deanne Heppelman. Allison Luella Metzler. Ryan Allen Stefanski. Ryan Michael Aluski. Andrew Michael Bistak. Adam Boyd Hadadil. Kyle J. Gobb. Catherine Annette Avila. Jeffrey M. C. Kimberly Michelle Fritz. Richard Stephen Anderson Lipcat. Mark Andrew Bugay. Brian C. Duxbury. Laura Ann Schneider. Ryan Zachary Westerberg. Jeanette Ruth Claus. Brian Robert Fenjick. Matt Allen Polsky. Nicole Marie Hallett. Matthew Ginto. Nicholas Dale Economist. Jennifer Lynn Dama. Jonathan R. Sorese. Anthony A. Orlando. Peter J. Yai. Scott E. Holdhart. Kate E. Runner. Stephen Richard Sloan. Haley Ann Fripp. Michael Ginto. Ronald A. Creo Jr. Carla M. Verbati. Anthony James DeMora. Amy Carol Bellino. Bethany Marie Majeski. Nathan E. Karn. Nicole Marie Bellino. Evan Matthew Stefanko. Matthew Edward Joseph. George Michael Cooley. Joseph Anthony Fritz. Andrea Marie Gann. Kyle Robert Schreiber. Jason John Sanek. Jennifer Rose Dulick. Mario John Ventura. Brendan James Fitzgerald. Desiree Jeanette Shaver. Daniel Thomas Kurtz. Edwin J. Laha III. Sarah Teresa Cook. David William Lintat. Philip Gerard Moeller. Julia Eileen Engelhardt. Genevieve Nicole Morgan. Thomas Joseph Long. Bethany Joy Bruni. Karen Marie Macniak. Justin Matthew Westlow. Mallory Ann Moran. Kyle D. Condick. Jennifer Lynn Riga. Joshua Alexander Payne. Emily Christine Bowers. Christopher Allen Holbeck. Carolyn Grace Knoll. Brian Michael Pennington. Rachel Alexis Smith. Daniel Thomas Basco. Megan Marie Bellata.
President Jessica L. LaRosa. And Class President Carly Marie Shahaki. Congratulations and good luck to our new alumni, class 2002.